Welcome to the Fast Mode Videocasts. Joining us today is Serge Melle, the Director of Product Marketing, IP-Optical Networks at Nokia. Welcome, Serge.
Thank you, Tara. Very happy to be here and great to be talking with the Fast Mode again.
So, following up on our interview in 2021 on the topic of 400G everywhere, optimizing IP-Optical Networks with next-gen coherent optics. Today, we would like to dive deeper into how coherent optics are transforming today's networks.
Sure, my pleasure. It'd be great to talk about that some more. And there's been a lot of developments in this space, so this will be hopefully very informative.
Okay, let's start. There's been a lot of talk in optical networking about fifth generation coherent optics. Can you describe what these are?
So fifth generation coherent optics fundamentally are leveraging the latest generation of silicon CMOS node geometry, specifically 7-nanometer silicon, to enable the coherent DSPs. What's a little different around fifth generation coherent optics is that next generation of silicon node technology is being leveraged one of two ways, either to reduce the power consumption for DSPs, and with that enable the integration of coherent optics in pluggable coherent modules that can be used in both routers and transport gear, or to provide higher baud rates for high performance coherent optics that maximize the capacity reach. In both cases, what we're seeing with fifth generation coherent optics is these are being integrated in what's called digital coherent optic modules. That means it's a fully integrated module that has both the coherent DSP, the optics, as well as all the control microelectronics. And these are then packaged either in standardized form factors like QSFP-DD or CFP2, and are therefore pluggable for use in different platforms, or they're implemented in proprietary pluggable DCO modules that can then be used as embedded modules in different optical transport systems. And really having both sets of options with fifth generation coherent optics allows network operators to essentially pick the most cost-effective and suitable set of coherent optics for their application between metro, regional, or challenging long-haul and subsea type of applications.
Great. Can you describe what customers are looking for when they evaluate fifth generation coherent optics? What challenges are they looking to address?
Well, the key challenge that customers have is scaling network capacity in the most cost-efficient manner. And so the solutions for that may vary depending on the places in the network. In metro and access type of applications, pluggable coherent optics operating up to 400 gigabits per wavelength provide a very cost-effective modular way to be able to scale network capacity. But at the same time, these pluggable coherent optics don't have the capacity reach to be used in long-haul or subsea applications. And then this is where you see super coherent or performance-optimized fifth-generation coherent optics then being used, where these can then operate at rates of 400 gig, 600 gig or more, in regional long-haul and subsea type of applications. And it's really having the ability to then use either set of coherent optics optimized to the application that provides customers essentially the lowest total cost of ownership for use in their networks.
Okay, so what are some of the characteristics of fifth-gen coherent optics, both pluggable and performance-optimized? And why would customers use one over the other?
That's a great question. So let's start with pluggable coherent optics. So these all operate up to 400 gigabits per second and really fall into three categories. You have 400ZR in a router pluggable QSFP-DD form factor that's really optimized for single span, point-to-point connections, really focused for either metro access or metro data center interconnect applications. Now, a very similar capability or extension to 400ZR is the 400 gig ZR+, and essentially that adds more operating modes where you can operate at 300, 200, or 100 gigs per wavelength. But the biggest difference is essentially the ability to get more optical reach. So that means being able to operate over several hundreds of kilometers in a pure point-to-point application, and being able to be deployed then in metro access rings or aggregation rings, for example. However, one of the limitations of 400 gig ZR plus is essentially limited reach, especially in ROADM type of networks that are very prevalent in network operators applications. And this is where the 400 gig multi-haul module, packaged in a CFP2 form factor, really provides some very important enhancements, being able to operate then across multiple ROADM pass-throughs in metro access, aggregation, metro and regional core networks as well. And essentially all of these pluggable coherent modules can be used in either router platforms or optical transport platforms. So lots of flexibility to use them in the right platform for the application. And then complementing these are the fifth generation super coherent or performance optimized coherent optics. So these implement many more features, really optimized for enhancing the capacity reach performance of the coherent optics, essentially being able to operate at the highest bit rates possible over the longest distances possible. And with that, enable their use in long haul networks, also in subsea, transoceanic applications. And typically these fifth generation high performance coherent optics implement a much higher gain forward error correction. They implement capabilities like probabilistic constellation shaping that essentially adapts to always maximizing the capacity reach performance on a given span, and also have higher performance optics that enable better OSNR in the link.
Right. Okay, so what are some of the new innovations that help drive the capacity reach improvements in PSEV supercoherent optics?
So as I was mentioning, supercoherent optics implement things like high gain forward error correction. One of the unique features that Nokia has implemented in our PSE5 is essentially a low overhead, high gain FEC. And what that means is that there's a reduced amount of the total bits that need to be transmitted that are allocated to the FEC overhead, but the performance remains the same. And essentially what that means is you can either carry more payload, so more capacity for a given distance, or for a given payload capacity for a certain amount of bits that are being transmitted, you can go further. And essentially that low overhead, high performance forward error correction algorithm works hand in glove with our probabilistic constellation shaping to be able to essentially then get the maximum capacity reach performance. And then another really unique feature of the PSE5 supercoherent optics is what we call continuous baud rate adjustment. So essentially there's a well-known theory in the industry called Shannon's limit that essentially defines the best performance that you can achieve on any given link. And what a lot of coherent optics do is they try to approach that limit, but they do that in a staircase way. So they have somewhat granular adjustments of PCS that sometimes gives the best possible performance and sometimes gets close, but not as close as you can. What the continuous baud rate adjustment feature of PSE5S enables is essentially always being able to optimize to the best achievable performance closest to the Shannon limit on any given link. So we're continuously adjusting the baud rate and with that the PCS shaping so that you always get the best performance. And what that means at the end of the day is enabling network operators to maximize the fiber capacity on any given fiber. So they can always get the most number of channels at the most optimized baud rate in their fiber spans.
Okay, great. Okay, so what is Nokia doing around fifth gen coherent optics? Are you focusing on one area or all? And how will Nokia utilize this in its transport products?
One of the key parts of Nokia's strategy is that we're working and have introduced both sets of fifth generation coherent optics, both the pluggable 400 gig low power optimized optics, as well as the high performance super coherent optics for challenging spans. All of our pluggable coherent optics are available for use in both our router platforms and can be used in our optical transport systems as well. And then our high performance coherent optics are implemented across our optical transport platforms, both integrated transponder line system platforms like the PSS, our integrated packet OTN switching platforms like the PSSX family, and then finally our compact modular and SLTE platforms, the PSIN. And so what that enables is for customers to be able to leverage fifth generation coherent optics across different platforms in their networks, either routers or optical transport equipment, and then optimize the type of coherent optics being used to the application, either the pluggable coherent optics for metro access type of applications or the high performance coherent optics for regional long haul and subsea applications.
Those are really some major enhancements. How are customers using this? And do you have any examples of the customers?
So yeah, so for example, on our pluggable 400 gig coherent optics, those are available across our routing portfolio. So those are being used by customers that are essentially looking to integrate the coherent capability into the router, and with that, not deploy a standalone optical transport box. And then those then carried over our optical line systems. Now, complementing that, in metro type of applications, our CFP2 pluggable modules are being used by customers to essentially scale network capacity in their metro networks. And by leveraging an optical transport platform for doing that, they can do subrate aggregation, for example, mapping multiple 100 gigabit Ethernet clients onto wavelengths. And they're also able to bring some additional functionality like OTN performance management capabilities or encryption capabilities with that CFP2 DCO module used in our optical transport platforms. And then our super coherent optics are being used by customers that are looking to scale capacity on regional long haul and subsea links. So we've actually demonstrated some pretty groundbreaking real world performance with PSC-5S, for example, being deployed to scale up to 600 gigabits of capacity per wavelength over 1,000 or more kilometers in real world networks that have very challenging fiber spans through multiple ROADM pass-throughs. And essentially that's the main application where our customers are deploying PSC-5S, is to scale the network capacity in their regional long haul or even ultra long haul networks. And then also being able to support up to 400 gigabits per wavelength of transmission capacity on transoceanic fiber subsea cables. So to be able to provide very important scaling in those networks as well.
Okay. Wow, Serge. That's really lots of great information about Nokia's super coherent optics, and excited to see these deployments. Thank you, Serge, for sharing these with us.
Well, thank you very much, Tara. It's been great talking with you and being able to share this information with your viewers.
And for more information on Nokia's fifth generation coherent optics, visit Photonic Service Engine webpage at the link below. It's at www.nokia.com, Networks Technologies Photonic Service Engine. So bye, and see you again in our next videocast.
Thank you very much, and goodbye, everybody.